Well, good morning, and thank you for joining us for a dose of hope today, our daily dose, which is we need this daily, just like we need to eat. We need to take in the truth of God, and hopefully I can give you a chance to have some truth today. What a great theme this week about fathers. You know, fathers have, I think in our culture today, kind of have a bad rap. There's not a lot of great examples, but, on television and things like that, but there are great fathers out there, or our country and our society, our neighborhoods and our families would not be advancing. And if you're watching this and you are fatherless and don't have a father, there are those out there who are willing. And a great place to look is the church. And so ask and check out the possibility of connecting to a mentor or a father. They're wonderful. Well, there's so many great teachings. I'm sure you're hearing some great ones this week. But what I'd like to kind of share with you is just kind of a little bit of a perspective or bend of what fathers do and how important it is to have them in your life. The scriptures talk to us about, in Malachi, the father's hearts return to the children, the children to the fathers, speaking about significant transformation in the church, something that will be foundational. I believe that has happened over the last 20 years. We have learned about the father heart of God and how important that is in the last 20 years, and a revealing of that has been so amazing. So we realize that God loves us, cares for us unconditionally. The other thing that Paul talks about is he says there's a lot of teachers, but there's not a lot of fathers. What does that mean? You know, in that, it's so interesting that is true, because teachers give information, but fathers do an impartation. And, knowledge is one thing, but I think a father does something very special. He applies that knowledge, helping you to apply it rightly, which is the beginning of wisdom, really. It's a tone, like we know in the scriptures, the beginning of wisdom is to hate the evil way, the froward mouth, those things in Proverbs that are so powerful. But the application of knowledge becomes wisdom. I think sometimes only a father can do that. The parallel can be a craftsman, a great woodworker will teach a young person he's mentoring to respect the wood, to understand what it's for and how to cultivate it and bring it out. It's different than just building something. It's crafting something, and something with beauty and power, and brings out the best. So that's a little parallel, like a father. Well, three things I want to share that I think is really important. Fathers, in their applying of knowledge, it's a lot of timing, like how the ebb and flow of life is. And I think there's some three very important things. Number one, fathers release confidence. The best parallel I've seen to that is, they certainly, fathers release significance, identity, authority, and calling in a young person's life, a daughter or a son, But that confidence is kind of an anchor in your life. One of the best things I've seen is my sons are athletes, on the field, they have a good coach. A good coach will see who they are and play into that. In other words, bring that strength out. Even though they have weaknesses, if you can bring the strength out, that's really important. And we also know in scripture it says that train up a child in the way he would go, and when he is old, he will not depart from it. That word way, which is so important, and me being a father, I've shared with my sons, is like the way of a serpent on a rock, an eagle in the air. We know that set of scripture. In other words, the way that being was meant to be or called to be. It's our great honor as a father and parents that we see children and we see how wonderfully they're made and how they're bent, whether to be evangelistic or to be studious or to be, a great leader, all those things. And we train our children, don't ignore the good things you've got. Not everybody can be that way. I've told my sons, not everyone can be the athlete you are, the leader that you are, the musician you are. We all have mistakes and lackings, but play to your strengths and you'll be strong. And that confidence is really important. It's the anchor that connects us relationally to God. And that touches his love for us personally, his touch in our life, that we have a certain way of being and he pulls that out of us. That anchors us. And so confidence is real important. And we gain confidence certainly in all kinds of relationships, true friendships and true good coaches and all those things. But fathers really see who we are, have only our benefit at stake, not theirs, but they want to see you become the best person you can be. Second thing I think is really important that a father does is he helps us in our determination. What do you mean, John? Well, the way that we pursue life, or what we give ourselves to, really the power to give is really about determination. How determined are you? When we give our life to certain things, and I think fathers are there to hold that line, like, no, don't get involved in that. Get involved in this. You know, no, don't waste your life in that. Give your life to that. It's really developing our determination, our strength, and our application of that is just how we, what we give our life to, what we give our time to, our talent to, our treasure to, is the things that really bring a harvest in our life. And I've been there as a father to say many times, like, I love you, David, Michael, Brian, but this is the boundary, because you need to give your life to the things that will give you life. I'm not trying to control or manipulate you, but I am here to keep sure, make sure you know that boundary, and you're going to end up getting involved in the things that bring life back to you. So your determination, the power to give yourself, is really important. And that's the second thing. The third one is humility. Oh, yeah, John, that's always the answer in Christendom, is humility. Well, it's not that we're talking about being humble like a doormat, but the bending of your life to work with God and not to kick against the goads like Paul was fighting all the time. It's almost like God intervened to say, Paul, you're wearing yourself out, raising your head and not realizing you're fighting the wrong fight. You've got to humble yourself to work with me and then to embrace the things that come against you so that you can score off of those. And until you humble yourself and to work with life as it comes to you, certainly fight for the good things, but work with surrender and see that you can work with me to overcome, and you can't do it in your own strength. And a father really is good about that, and I've watched my sons really grow in humility. I mean, first to become a husband, second to become a father, and when you do that, what happens is that you end up surrendering your life in order to gain your life. It's just this beautiful judo move in the spirit. And I've seen their hearts expand and then become more themselves because they've humbled themselves and given their life away, working with the circumstances, working with the people in their lives, rather than trying to dominate them, but work with them to bring God's love to bear. So three things. Confidence. Where do you get your confidence? Certainly relationally and to fathers who show you the ebb and flow of life. Secondly, determination. How do you develop that determination? By giving yourself to the right things. And lastly, humility. By surrendering in a way to find God's way through things and to give your life away, and then you get it back. So just some thoughts on fathering and loving, and it's a great honor to be a part of that. And we don't do it perfectly, but God brings that perfect because he adds to every time because of his grace. Well, I hope this helped you, and I am so thrilled to be able to share with you. And if you get through your day today, don't forget to turn your heart to the Father in heaven and say, thank you for this life you've given me. Thanks for joining me. Have a great, great day.